The winner is Sydney, Australia.
It was the moment that made Australian history, and everyone had a chance to join in. But as the Olympic torch made its way around the country, there was one question on everybody's lips. Who would light the cauldron at the opening ceremony? Now, 20 years on, Cathy Freeman reveals a long-held secret for the very first time.
I didn't keep it top secret. I felt it was really important to tell my two training partners because athletes who train very closely with other training partners can read each other really well.
In the end, our female sporting heroes of the past quite literally passed the torch to an Olympic champion of the very near future.
I had to walk across, I looked like I was walking across the water lit the cauldron, lit the flame, and then it rose up around me. Which kind of still gives me shivers when I think about it in my mind.
Then the cauldron jolted to a standstill.
And so the voice down the line, I can't repeat, there was this reaction of, panic, a reaction of sort of panic. And so he's just then told me, just turn around and acknowledge the crowd again, hold the flame up.
And she did for 3 agonisingly long minutes.
I definitely felt like I had to give the impression that everything was fine, and it was fine eventually. I feel very proud. And I think, you know, the older I get, the more that time goes by, the more precious that memory becomes, actually.
I said it would be stressful.
And welcome back to our very special event here at Sydney Olympic Park as we get set to relight the Sydney 2000 Olympic cauldron. Now, the Sydney 2000 Olympic Games are still regarded as the best Olympic Games ever. 34 world records were set and Aussie names were written into the history books. From Cathy Freeman's 400 metres victory to 17-year-old Ian Thorpe breaking his own world record in the pool, there were so many magical moments for the Australian team. In the Paralympics, Australia finished at the top of the medal tally for the first and only time with 63 gold medals, 39 silver and 47 bronze medals. And Olympic swimmer Ian Thorpe and Paralympic wheelchair racer Louise Savage join us now. Guys, great to have you back here. Thorpe, what was that like as a 17-year-old, living that moment? Were you aware of how big it was then?
Yes, I was. I didn't know what the Olympics was going to be like, but I knew that it was, you know, it would be a big moment. And it was mostly because people would tell me I won tickets to the ballot to go to the swimming on the first night. And then they'd add something which kind of freaked me out. I can't wait to see you win your first Olympic gold medal, which, you know, it is a lot of pressure. And, you know, I went in and, you know, we hadn't won a gold medal at that stage. We thought we'd win one in the triathlon earlier in the day. So it was a big night, which is tomorrow night. You know, the night before, I was watching all of what happened and unfolded with Catherine at the opening ceremony on TV.
And Louise, for you, you got a couple of goes at competing in that stadium, but just tell us about the feeling of having 110,000 Australians mostly cheering you home down that straight.
Yeah, I was very, very nervous before the race and a little bit crooked too. So, it was something probably I'll never experience ever again. So 110,000 people knowing that at least 90% of them were going for me. So it was fantastic. It was a surreal feeling. And obviously I won the race, but I did my victory lap and I wish I'd done 2 now. So, but it was fantastic and phenomenal. And, of course, I had to come back and do it all again for the Paralympics. So, yeah, it was an amazing time in my life.
Thorpe, for you, when you look back at that anniversary tomorrow night, the night that you grabbed that gold medal, and then you came back in the 4x100, was that the most special night of your swimming career, do you think?
Yes, it is. It is. It quite simply is because it was at home. And it was a moment in time that we created Australian kind of sporting history. In an event, we weren't expected to win the 4x100, but for some odd reason, everyone believed that we could, and we thought we could. We just didn't know how we were going to do it. But I arrived back that night to the village at about 1 a.m. And the people that were in the food hall, because I hadn't eaten anything after this, you know, there was probably 30 people, and all of them stood up and applauded me as I walked in, which was, you know, what the spirit of the games are. Athletes from all around the world that are up at that time that have just got back.
What amazing. Guys, thanks for joining us today. Now, Cathy Freeman, our hometown hero, made history at the Sydney Olympic Games. As she lit this magnificent cauldron behind us, she actually united a nation in doing so. And now, 20 years after that landmark event, she has a message for Australia.
Hi, everybody. I'm sorry I can't be with you there. Unfortunately, level 4 COVID restrictions have me here in Melbourne. I'm excited about these celebrations. When I reflect back on lighting the cauldron 20 years ago, the words that come to my mind are surreal and just simply magnificent. When Coetzee asked me to do the honours of lighting the cauldron, I was really taken aback. I was really struggling to come to terms with it because I just felt there were a few other people who I thought who were so deserving of the honour, and I almost felt, oh geez, you know, me? You want me? I was so honoured. It's at times like these that I reflect and I ponder the power of sport and the difference that sport can make in all of our lives. I also understand that John or Coetzee, Ian and Louise are there on hand, and I'm sure it will make the occasion that much more special. I also want to acknowledge the two young Australian athletes, our athletes of the future, who are going to be relighting the cauldron. And I think that's wonderful. It's very lovely.
So Cathy has handed that honour to two future stars. Those two future stars are Tanaya Logan and Tamsin Colley. They've been nominated by Cathy to relight the cauldron on her behalf. And they've been given a huge honour to follow in the footsteps of that sporting legend 20 years on. Tanaya is a basketball star. Tamsin has already represented Australia in athletics and at the Rio Paralympic Games as a 13-year-old. The girls go to position. There we have it, the relighting of the Sydney 2000 Olympic cauldron. Such a beautiful moment to see it back in this park again and relit. To mark this 20 years on, so many memories with it as well. That great night 20 years ago when we celebrated the opening of the best Olympic Games ever. And what a proud moment for both Tanaya and Tamsin, given the honour by Cathy Freeman to carry out the duty of relighting the cauldron. There you have it, the spirit of the Games reignited here in Sydney Olympic Park 20 years on, a day to celebrate for so many Australians, a day to relive some great memories from 20 years ago, a sporting event that really put us on the world map and also had us earn incredible respect on the world sporting stage. But a moment that here in Australia we have all savoured, that we've enjoyed, and that we have used as a legacy to build our sporting pride right around the country. Thanks, everyone. An incredible moment. Great to see the Olympic cauldron relit back here in the park.
Yeah, that's right. And it all went according to plan this time.
Yeah. Are you trying to make me cry? Honestly, this is beautiful. And cue the Man from Snoring River music as well.
It's fantastic.
Brilliant sight to see.
Thank you, Brett.